Good afternoon, everybody. My name's Will. I work with Speedcast, and we just ordered a Starlink Maritime system. So when you order the system online, place the order for the Maritime kit, these four boxes are what you get. So we ordered it about a week ago, and I've been tracking the FedEx tracking numbers they sent ever since. Just got onto the doorstep today, and we're going to do an unboxing. Very nice poster for your wall. And then injection molded plastic top. And then underneath you can see a very nicely packed Starlink kit. It's got the base, comes out. Piece of plastic that held the base on top of this. And then the antenna itself. So we have a nice, I think it's 22 by 20 inch panel antenna. Looks like it's got a cable running into the pole at the bottom of it mounted. This pole articulates so that it can align itself when we start it up. A couple small holes in the back here. So from a sealed up perspective, it seems like it's sealed pretty good. I think when it goes into the maritime environment, these will be obviously on the bottom, so less of an issue that way. Maybe an adapter. Beneath it, instructions in large print. Beneath that, you can see the cabling. There's a Wi-Fi router. Looks like a cover for it. Another cable, probably connecting the power source to the router. Power adapter. This looks like another power cable. And then some length of cord. We'll have to see how long this cord is when we open it up. But it does look to be hard plugged into that. And then this device here, which is some kind of a power converter. So for now, let's get this out. So the Wi-Fi router is separate. It is. And a quarter inches by 5 3/4 inches approximately. Has a power cord that does look to be coming able to come out. Pull it out. Then we have a really heavy brick. There does seem to be this hole for a grounding connection on it. It looks like it's made to sit flat like this. There's some feet that go along with it. This device is 11 and a half inches, roughly by 6.5 inches. 110 outlet. The website says it takes 325 watts. The plug-in, this goes to your Wi-Fi router. Looks like a USB-C cable, but it's a little bit different, so not quite exactly the same. And then you have the same cable going up to the Starlink unit. So I don't know how to unplug the Starlink in the back yet. But for those who are trying to route this through a maritime environment, this cable looks to need a hole of about 3/4 inch to be able to get the cabling through. And then the cable itself is about just under 3/8. Simple pull through here. So we get another cover and a pipe adapter. It has holes for screws to go into it on three sides. This looks like it fits into the corresponding piece on the bottom of the antenna. There's a hardware kit that goes with it, some set screws and an Allen wrench, and large print instructions with some very small print on the opposite side in many different languages. So we won't open the other pull kit on the unboxing. I do want to open the other antenna kit to see if it's exactly the same or if there's something that's different about that kit versus this kit. the kit beneath it, and exactly the same kit on this side as the other side. It looks like the exception is I have a longer one of these cables. It looks like an RJ45 with a little specific USB style connector. It looks to have some instructions that I didn't see in the other ones. But other than that, you have the same Wi-Fi router. You have a very similar box to be plugged in. These connections do all come out, which is good news. So this is the Starlink Maritime Kit. Thanks, everyone.